Hey guys, welcome to me reacting to False Advertising, Scott the Waz by Scott the Waz. Now, I already know what this is about, because I know what false advertising is. I've seen it done many times before in the film industry, and also in TV shows, and basically everything. There obviously is there's false advertising in everything, where you see, you know, something being advertised, and then it's not really the game or the movie, or, you know, it's like only the segment at the end, you know. Sort of like that, you know, kind of like clickbait. But anyways, guys, we're jinxing the script from the script of Scott the Waz thing, so let's just get right into it.
Hey y'all, Scott here. Please, for the love of God, don't mind me. I'm just doing some touch-ups to my high school yearbook photo. You think I'm gonna do retakes 9 years later? I've been having trouble going to sleep thinking about what people thought of me back then.
Clearly a different book with a cover.
I actually took it down, I didn't make it too much. Telling the truth.
True. It's actually pretty funny.
False advertising is how many companies roll. I've seen those fast food comparison shots. This is what's advertised, and this is what I got.
Yeah.
Most of the time for marketing, it represents the final product. Some color correction, just lighting, a few angles here and there. Boom, good enough for air. When it comes to video games,
yeah, true.
Why show actual gameplay in your ad when you can show something that's neither a game nor being played?
True. True. You can just show a gameplay trailer. Or not gameplay trailer. You show a trailer.
Advertisers know they could just show you what the actual game is going to be like. Or they could visualize what it will feel like.
Garbage.
Sometimes advertisers don't necessarily lie, but the way they're set up, you come in with certain expectations. With the Mario Galaxy commercials and box art, I thought you could fly through space just like this to each of the galaxies. Instead, they just play a cutscene of Mario flying. Flying game, it would mostly just be an automated thing going from one place to another. You did get a power-up late in the game, the Red Star, and that let you freely fly for a decent amount of time, but it was only in one level and the hub world.
True, but I mean, like how does that really count?
Mario Galaxy just ended up being my favorite game of all time. I'll take the single tier. This is kind of the mentality of a lot of old-school box art. Box art in general is supposed to be an artistic...
Oh, yeah, box art in the... Yeah. Because back then, people based it on box art, like how this looked, the game looked.
Obviously, these take purpleize the best and most defining moments of the game to make for a great and appealing piece of art.
Because the internet wasn't a thing back then.
Atari thought we were idiots. This is misleading because under the right mindset, the game...
Oh, that's Atari Golf.
You thought we were past this level of deception? Oh, no, no, no. See, many have noticed how box art has become more in line with what we expect out of our games these days. But the angst behind the Atari box art lives on in the form of trailers. We could show the product and get excited, or we could not show the product and get people excited and pissed eventually. Hey, sometimes you just have to show something. And if that something isn't enough, America's biggest fear becomes a reality. The gamers will revolt. So it's obviously enticing to make...
Oh, yeah, that. Yeah.
Not in the game, but we can make it happen in the game, right? This is how legends are
born. Oh god, Dead Island, yeah, that's the greatest.
One of the best ones of all time.
Most well known, yeah. Yeah, this cinematic trailer was insane.
Dead Island on the map for so many players. This trailer was the first time I had even heard of the game.
Yeah, and then you actually play the game, and it's literal dogs.
Here's the first thing you see putting the disc in. Shrunken head, broken legs, body parts on the concrete. I'm not saying Dead Island is a bad game at all, but the trailer and the game are two completely different beasts.
Yeah.
The game is still fairly serious, but not as serious or emotionally gripping as the trailer would lead you to believe. These characters have nothing to do with the game, other than showing remnants of the outbreak as it first occurred on the island. The developer Techland even went into the game after the trailer came out to try to adjust the tone as much as possible to be more in line with it. But these still feel like two different things.
Yeah.
Powerful marketing can be, making you want something you had no prior interest in. But this was a case of false advertising just because we let somebody talented make our trailer. Oops. Sometimes false advertising is very deliberate as it sets you up for a massive shock while playing the game. Metal Gear Solid 2 is a prime example. Play a snake the whole game? Nah, you're playing the rest of the game as this new character, right? A Final Fantasy VII Remake. The title literally involving the word remake, it sets you to expect a story to basically follow the same steps as the original. Also, the entirety of the original.
Oh, yeah.
This was a fucking lie. The last was part two, on top of pulling the same Metal Gear Solid joke of, you thought you were playing as this character? Laugh. They also altered certain cutscenes for its trailers to make the character Joel look older in them, so that way, with viewers knowing he's aged, they were led to believe he was in more of the game than he really was. In reality, they altered flashback scenes, made him look older, and put them in the trailer. See, I don't know.
Oh, what?
False advertising.
My bad.
Rather, it's leading players in another direction or just not showing things to avoid spoilers. So it's just being an ass. But then we have just the flat out lies. Some of the most despicable, loathsome moments in the video game industry. The Simpsons game. This game had the audacity to say in its E3 2007 trailer it was releasing on every platform ever made. People would assume that's a joke.
Jaguar as well?
Some people genuinely thought this game was coming to all these platforms. You had to re-release the trailer. The voiceover was the same, but the platforms showcased were not true. Well, I said it was ridiculous for anybody to assume the original trailer was.
Well, yeah, they were probably doing it for satire.
The platform choices were incredibly misleading. The Game Boy Advance and GameCube were still being supported at this time, so out of all platforms to put there as a joke, those are really odd choices considering.
Yeah, so it was meant to be a joke.
GameCube version in 2007. Or the victim. The box itself can be pretty deceitful sometimes. Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild on Wii U says it supports the Wii Remote and Nunchuck and Classic Controller and lying. This was just a mess.
And lying?
Speculation in the early days of Breath of the Wild's development that it would allow players to use motion controls like the Skyward Sword on the Wii. Supporting one Wii Remote by itself, I think only Gravis speculated that. Doom on Sega Saturn says on the box that it's the original Doom in all of its glory when missing content. But then we have the flat disappointments.
Oh, yeah.
Gushers commercial as a kid, and in those, whenever somebody ate one, their entire head would turn into a giant fruit. So you never ate one for years out of fear, and one day you decided life is hell anyways. Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite. Oh, this collector's edition comes with stones.
I swear to God, if they're just eggs.
These have all been.
Are they actually?
Lies, though. If she's cheating on you, at least she's only doing it a little. Aliens, Colonial Marines was such a massive cluster of garbage. What the hell happened here? Gameplay demos shown were severely different from the final product.
Oh, what?
So much more sophisticated with good lighting, AI, animations, severe attention to detail. But upon release, we only have a few options here. See, this was.
It wasn't, it was not.
More so than others. But in the end, this was pure deceptive marketing. At E3 2012, the game was running on very specific work machines. It wasn't going to work on the consoles at the time, but they made it still not work. While it's not unplayable, Colonial Marines was a huge disappointment and showcases how companies would hurry up a game for major gameplay demos and end up releasing something not nearly as groundbreaking. It's crazy how far these studios would go to mask a title's true identity, which, to be fair, I'm sure they wanted Aliens to end up looking like this. The intention definitely wasn't to win everybody over at E3 and then leash. These gameplay demos are supposed to represent what they want the game to be, and if it actually turns out that way, well, it's great God's a fan. I mean, this demo looks like a fine-tuned PS4 Xbox One game, not a 360 title. But even then, the graphical downgrade isn't merely due to the consoles. It affected the PC version as well, and overall, everything was just of lower quality. It tricked millions into buying the game, thinking it would be this, when in reality, it was nothing but a shell of that. Watch Dogs
Wow. Game.
Severe fate, where it too looked light years better via the gameplay demo than in its final state. This was definitely because it was revealed quite early in the project's life. They didn't have to take hardware limitations into account nearly as much at this time compared to when you're finalizing everything about the game. And when it got to that point, I mean, the game still looks fine, but that E3 gameplay demo was beyond impressive. Watch Dogs at release was a somewhat buggy, generic, modern Ubisoft game.
Okay.
No Man's Sky was a huge letdown for me.
Oh, yeah.
Basically having an infinite amount of worlds to travel to in space. Of course, the ones they decided to showcase at E3 were the aliens of note. The game was supposed to feature procedurally generated worlds, and when you land on one, it was truly you discovering it. But in reality, the game launched as a boring experience where there was nothing to do, and the worlds weren't impressive. They didn't look as graphically decent as they did.
Yeah. It also took 15 minutes to load.
Note, that Watch Dogs wasn't the biggest downgrade. A decent game. No Man's Sky got a ton of updates, and at this point, it's pretty okay and does a better job.
Yeah, true. I heard it's actually not bad now.
One of the worst cases of things. Literally making a better-looking gameplay demo before release. Gameplay demos are supposed to be more trustworthy than cutscenes and cuts between them in gameplay all the time. The gameplay demo is supposed to show you what you're gonna get, because trailers can be incredibly misleading. The Killzone 2 trailer infamously was all CGI, even though it was animated in a way to make viewers think it was all gameplay. See, this was right before the PlayStation 3 was coming out.
Really?
At the time when we thought anything was possible on these consoles. If anybody could resurrect Christ, it would be the PS3. So many assume they weren't lying. This was gameplay. Now, Killzone 2 still looked quite good when it released, but the people who made this trailer, they're still going to hell. Tiger Woods PGA Tour 2009 on Wii. The commercial used Xbox 360 footage of the game with a Wii remote pointer. How did they think that would fly? EA explained the Wii footage.
What?
The HD footage from the 360 version and put the Wii remote pointer in
there. Wow.
That's a sin. But one game decided to do something innovative. The biggest example of false advertising of all time.
Yeah, really of course, of course. Yep, yep. Yeah, yeah, you gotta talk about this. Yeah.
Avoid the piss stain on my Xbox collection.
Yeah.
Cyberpunk 2077 was developed by CD Projekt Red, a developer highly regarded for their work on the Witcher series and their commitment to consumer-friendly practices. I mean, The Witcher 3 was a huge hit. Before that release, they announced they were working on a game based on the Cyberpunk series of tabletop RPGs. This was in 1964. Announced in 2017.
Yeah, like, of course.
In reality, the game was nowhere near starting full in development. Until The Witcher 3's final expansion released in 2016 for the team to actually start work. When this gameplay demo was fully revealed in 2018, jaws were dropped. This was such a detailed world with people walking around who have legitimate lives to live. If you would follow just one around, you would see them go about their day, go to their job, go home, and every single decision of yours would come back to bite you in the ass. And this is all without saying the game looks stunning. Just absolutely beautiful models and settings. The animations were amazing. It looked like the most advanced video game of all time. And guess what?
Yeah.
Delayed numerous times. Cyberpunk launched in a state that, well, the main issues stem from the console version. The PC version looked, ran, and worked the best, but it's still aside from that initial gameplay review. Most of the issues boiled down to how glitchy and unpolished the game could be at times.
Yeah, so it was mainly just console launch.
This is really what sells it. It's so detailed and feels like a genuine lived-in place. And being in a dystopian future, it's truly a world worth exploring and looking at every little minute thing. But everything around it just doesn't feel all too special. The gameplay isn't anything groundbreaking. It's a first-person open-world RPG involving shooting and driving segments. And well, this is bad, but it just isn't anything I haven't seen before. Anything that they talk
True.
About in the gameplay demo, like how advanced the non-playable characters are, just see him walking in a circle, going up to them and hitting the talk button, and they say one of like three repeated phrases to you. The same goes for the characters more integral to the story. They'll repeat some voice lines, which is fine, that's understandable. But this isn't the genre-defining game they made it out to be. It's a brilliantly designed world inside a game that feels like it's from 2013.
Yeah.
Abundant. And we're just talking about the PC version here. On Xbox One and PlayStation 4, not only were glitches even more all over the place, but the game ran like this, and that doesn't run well. Choppy frame rates, low resolution, the game would freeze and crash constantly, and this was the product of a giant marketing campaign pushed by investors and higher-ups who didn't understand how game development worked. They were
oh.
the release date, which by the time CD Projekt Red started development, would have given them less time to finish than The Witcher 3. And this project was so much more advanced with elements they've never worked with before. It just felt like a lot of choices they made didn't add up. Like, why do we have all this customization for our character? The game is almost exclusively played in the first person, and you barely ever see your character.
Yeah, what? He's right. He does make a good point.
And that frankly didn't exist yet. Much like other examples given, this demo was basically what developers were told to shoot for, and not what the game was, and no matter how much the developers said they needed more time, or if this wasn't possible, the marketing pushed Cyberpunk that much more. Did they really have to announce, hey, the game is finished, when the developer said, bullshit it is? Cyberpunk 2077 is a good game. It may not be for everybody, but at its core, this isn't a well-crafted experience, I think is a bit much. But I can't blame people for thinking that after such a disastrous launch and being lied to constantly. This was a case of a developer who was known for their goodwill and how players adored them, and higher-ups taking advantage of them. It's crazy to me how much these companies feel they need to lie when they know that it'll just come back to bite them in the ass. They take
True. Seriously. Everyone just went nuts on them. Yeah, that's so true.
Some people it is. That's why lying gang is so popular. Fix a problem now, deal with the repercussions later. Instead of telling the truth and causing some potential disappointment, then you don't have to deal with bigger problems a year from now. It's just sometimes marketing takes over projects. Marketers don't care. Their job is to get people interested. Even if it turns out to be over lies, well, that's more publicity for the project. I guarantee you, more people have talked about Cyberpunk and Aliens, Colonial Marines, and No Man's Sky because they were disasters compared to if they were as good as they were made out to be. And regardless of if discussion is positive or negative, it's still getting the name out there, which means false advertising for games will never go away. Games
True.
Advanced and think it's not good enough, so they pretty things up for reveals and just assume they'll get it working later. But as we can see, that's not the greatest risk to take.
I think the lesson we learned here is it's okay to be excited, it's also okay to be skeptical. But we need a way to make a full decision until something's out in the world and actual people are playing the game rather than snake people. Because liars are everywhere, they might even be staring you in the face.
Okay, I kind of like that ending bit. So yeah, this video actually was good. I enjoyed it. I like how he brings up, like, he talks about, you know, gameplay trailer. Well, not that. I mean, like, cinematic trailers and then also demos can, you know, lie. And then also, yeah, just, well, yeah, I guess that was basically it. But basically how game developers, or not developers, how, like, people can lie when making a game. And put out something that doesn't look like the thing that you want, you know? Especially like in gaming, especially with what I think the reveal trailers that they have at like E3 and stuff like that. Especially since that E3 is happening right now, it makes so much sense to talk about this. Because yeah, there could be a ton of things revealed at E3 that don't look how they look now. But yeah, anyways, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the like and subscribe to my channel. See you next one. Bye!